Okay, two things. First off, I lowered the intensity, I don't know what you call it, like the bit rate of the camera, so it records slower now. And I'm hoping that will mean the camera will stop turning itself off. I explained it to my dad, and he said, Google it. And yeah, I guess I should Google it if this doesn't work, but I think this will work based on what I think the problem is. And the second thing is, I took a Klarna around. The thing is, I don't know if it was around 11 or 12 because it puts you in a different state of mind after you take it. It's like it restarts your brain. It's almost like waking up from sleep, which is kind of unhealthy. So I took a Klarna around 11 or 12. I'm sorry about that. I took a Klarna around 11 or 12, and then I drank a Coca-Cola, and I believe I still have anxiety, so Coke is evil. But I love it, I love it. So I'm mostly just making this video because I don't want to go out for a walk because I don't know. I had really weird sleep and I woke up really refreshed. And I still feel mostly refreshed. Important, I took my muscle relaxant. So that might help me with control of my fingering. We'll see. But yeah, I'm making this video because I need to pass the time. I'm not killing time, I'm actually doing something productive. But I'm not gonna walk yet until, like, when I've been going on walks for a while, and when I go on for walks, I feel like I really need the walk, and I don't feel I need the walk right now, although it would be healthy. But because of my weird sleep, I think, like, maybe I should just chill out, you know? So anyways. Oh, right. I was thinking this video I would give myself a little tune-up. I have the weird feeling I'm out of tune. It's just a suspicion. And it has been a little while since I had a proper tune-up. Is this upside down? Yes, that's upside down. Okay. So, if you've been following my videos, you know that is an electric tuner. I think I'm too close to the amp. All right, that's there. That's quieter. Okay, so that's in tune. That's so close. I don't even want to play with it because it's delicate. But let's just do that. It's a very delicate. So far, nothing's majorly out of tune. But yeah, I wanted to check something. What did I want to check? Okay. I just wanted to see if that was how it works. There's a website and it goes EBD, no, EBCDAE, I think. And I wanted to know if it was upside down or not. Because with all this guitar instruction stuff, there's so much stuff that's just counterintuitive, as far as I can tell. That's pretty much right. You see, the tuner, and I believe the rest of the guitar world, say this note is the third note when it is the fourth furthest from my body. Assuming right-handed is. Like, people say right-handed is the typical way, so I don't know why they set it up like that. That's something that's counterintuitive. You hear the crinkles and shh. Please do not snap. Okay, the exact point where it crinkled, I think that's called crinkling. Someone, my friend called it crinkling, so I'm gonna call it crinkling. I don't know if that's, everyone calls it that or not. I don't know. Doesn't really matter. Okay, that was just about, according to the tuner, that was like the most perfect B ever. Wait, that's B? That's A. Oh yeah, so it is upside down. Okay, that's what I thought. So the charts are upside down. So that's what I like about those vertical charts instead of the horizontal charts. Vertical, I don't know. It was easier for me to figure out with vertical. And I know I played that really lightly, but that just went perfectly in tune, so. Strum doesn't sound too pleasant, but obviously nothing's fingered. That's a bit better. So, yeah, that's off. So now we can actually practice. Sorry if that was boring. And hurrah, the camera hasn't shut itself off yet, so maybe I fixed the problem. Thank you. Right, so that's the hardest one of the new ones I learned. And I learned that just today. So, you'll have to excuse me. Let's look at the chart. What have we missed? We missed D minor. Always forgetting about D minor. Well, okay, so maybe we should try to memorize. I mean, I just memorized C, and apparently in your sleep you go over the whole day and it gets stuck in your head and you can do it better the next day. But I just did like a perfect, that's exactly what it's supposed to be, I think. Am I getting too excited? Oh, actually, no, I'm doing it wrong, is why I thought it was good. But this might actually be something that is supposed to be done. I got all excited, like, whoa, I did it perfect, and the whole time I'm doing it wrong. Is that really what you want me to do? No, that's not what you want me to do. Okay. Wait a minute here. Am I skipping? Yes, I'm skipping. Then I should be skipping. Okay. So if anyone can tell me what I just did that was, I got excited about, if that was actually a chord, because it sounded good, but... just leave that and actually I think that's the one I was supposed to be learning. Oops. Wait, D minor. So I think I already know D minor. And then D. D is what I was saying that I had last time. Obviously my brain's not 100% if I can't remember stuff like this. Because I was so frustrated with the camera last time, I didn't even attempt G. Long time, I mean it's only been a week or two since I've been doing this, but long time viewers will know my frustration with G. And I'm told there's more than one way to make G, and this is just a shape, it's just a guideline. But I need to learn this because it is so infuriating to me. My fingers just... Am I that low? Yes. See, if this finger wants to be more like this than like that when it needs to be like that, and then like that, and then like that. That's what I'm supposed to do. Okay, so maybe that was actually a good strategy, approaching it from like way from. Because otherwise, if I'm just going like slithering around the neck, my fingers are naturally going to want to. Like, my fingers are used to holding things, so it wants to hold the guitar. But if I say I'm trying to reach something far away, the fingers get the idea better. And I don't know how I'm gonna get it. So I just did it correctly, which, yay me. But I don't know how I'm gonna transition into that quickly, because this whole slithering thing. That easiest chord right there. The slither works fine with that. I'm a little bit nervous because I feel like I'm actually attaining a basic level of competency. I hope that's not bragging. He's bragging. He's so full of himself. He thinks he has a basic level of competence. Yeah, see, whenever you put your ego forward, so I just have to press really hard with that finger, and that's the finger. Just have to remember to press hard. Unless I get a setup or something like that, which I do not think I am ready for. Plus, it's really expensive. On the first string, and I don't know if you heard it, but it was like a little bit of a sparkly, I don't know how to say it without sounding feminine, it was like glitter, or was, I don't know, but anyways. Confused with that. Okay. This. These two seem similar. Well, it's D and D minor, so... I mean, the fingering seems a lot different, but it also seems... Oh, it's not that different. Okay. And then... Just, that's a weird switch to have to make, though. Slightly different each time. I wasn't pressing down hard enough, I'm fairly sure. And I did everything including G, and it's still recorded, which is nice. So, we're at 22 minutes. It seems when I... If I could allow myself to claim that I was just jamming, I don't like the word jam. In terms of music. Maybe I just don't like actual jam. But yeah, if I was just like playing or whatever, it seems the playing takes up some time. And I talked, of course. I haven't been practicing this as much as the other stuff. And you guys have seen pretty much all my practice, or you have the potential to. But I'm not pressing hard enough, I'm not sustaining enough. I'm just working on raw memory skills. Obviously, I was just picking blind with my thumb, which, I don't know, I think that's something you kind of have to learn, I don't think I can just pick blind at will, but when I'm doing this, I can pick blind a little bit. And by blind, I mean I wasn't looking down where my thumb was. So I don't know if I got better at that, or if that's just a really simple thing. What? Okay, let's start over. Oh, okay. What? Okay. One day my friend wrote this chart out for me by hand. I guess he couldn't find the link by Googling it. And I feel kind of bad that I spend so little time trying to master this part of, the lessons I'm teaching myself, because, by hand I mean like by mouse, and he didn't just press on the keyboard, so it probably took him like 30 seconds, so it's probably not a big deal, but like there's something personal about this particular chart. And I'm just ignoring it. Not ignoring it. I'm just not spending enough time with it. So, I think that sounds kind of depressing, so I want to jam some more. I'm being too blind. There's too much blindness. Okay, let's not be there was no orgasmic moment of joy, but I felt my body energy, like especially in the neck, I just felt it go whoosh, and I slumped. So I could keep playing, but I would be playing as a slumped energy person, which might be interesting, but I'm not going to do. So thank you for watching. And usually I unplug things after I turn it off, but I don't know. For some reason I'm doing it different. Goodbye.